Hi everyone, it's Janis here with a new episode to help you build better daily structure and be in control of your life. As humans, we are irrational. We make snap decisions based on our emotions and we believe in things that we haven't investigated. But there is a tool that we can learn if we want to make more informed decisions that are in line with our beliefs, and that is logic. Today, we'll take a look at the book called The Art of Logic to learn how to make sense in a world that doesn't. If this is your first time on this channel, then make sure you subscribe and hit the bell icon to get updates on my latest videos on time management and productivity. Also consider joining my free productivity mastermind group, where I do live coaching calls and live Q&As, where you have a chance to ask me any questions. For logic to be useful, we have to realize its limitations and how to apply it correctly, as it is not always the best option. So let's take a look at how logic works and how we can apply it in the different situations of our life. Number one, how logic works. Logic describes something that comes out from clear reasoning. It's how things are connected to each other to make sense. If you wake up early, then you'll get more accomplished. If you complete your homework, then you'll get better grades. And if you hit the gym, then you'll become stronger. These are all logical elements that follow each other, and most of our life is combined with logical events just like these. The first step to understanding logic is to understand that it takes you out from the real world and into somewhere abstract. In this way, logic gives you permission to ignore certain aspects of reality. This means that you can better examine the situation without getting caught into details. Number two, logic and arguments. During the argument, we often lose control, and instead of stating facts, we shout and simply repeat that our way is the right one. You have probably been in a situation where you have to argue with another party or convince someone about your idea. Your business partner might suggest that you should expand your online brand using Facebook, but you want to do it on Instagram, and then you keep going backwards and forwards. This doesn't help us to win our argument or consider it from another perspective. But if we can replace this behavior with logic, then we can get a greater insight into the issue. First of all, it's important to start putting down some facts about why each platform would be better to grow the business. One thing that I should point out here is to be aware of assumptions, so the facts that you're putting forward should be validated. Also, you need to make sure that you both are not simply attached to your ego, as the main goal of this decision should be to expand and grow your business. Number three, logic and emotions. One of the reasons why people are struggling to put more logic into their lives is because emotions are stronger than logic. If you catch yourself becoming emotional about an argument or even while making a decision, a great way to get yourself back into logic is to play reasonable skepticism. Let's say that you're trying to decide what team management platform you're going to use, and you have two alternatives. One side of you thinks that Basecamp would be the best option, while other part of you think that the Trello would be a better option. First, you should identify all the reasons why each option is better, and then you have to validate each reason to meet the ultimate goal of picking the right team management platform. Number four, when not to use logic. While the logic is useful in many instances, in some situations, using the logic is not the best option to arrive at the best destination. Logic can help you to narrow down the choices when you have specific features in the product that you want to choose, but sometimes logic is not necessary. For example, when you're choosing what clothes you want to buy, you don't really have to use logic. You can simply choose something that you like. The same goes when you decide what to eat. Of course, if you're trying to lose weight, then you can use logic to pick less calorie-dense foods. But other than that, you don't need logic to select your meals. So it's important to realize that there is no need to always find a logical solution in all situations of life. Number five, clarify your beliefs. The logic itself doesn't have a starting point, so we have to choose the starting point by ourselves, and our starting point will be our beliefs, things that we believe to be true. Typically, your beliefs are shaped by how you're raised and educated, the society you live in, and your personal experiences. To identify your beliefs, you have to reflect on what you believe to be true. This will be your starting point, where you can start to build upon. This goes to show that different people will have different angles of how they see the situation. So don't be surprised if you get into an argument. Number 6, it's not always white or black. Another important aspect that needs to be pointed out is that logic will not always bring you to the clear answer. People like to hear straight answers, like yes and no, or right and wrong, because then they don't have to worry about it. But life is not that simple. Sometimes the answer is maybe or yes, but, as there is always a gray area between both spectrums. It's not just white or black. And the same applies when we try to use logic in our life. It will not always deliver straight up answer that you can take action on. So accept it as a fact and let your emotions or gut to make a final decision before you move on. Number 7, combine emotions and logic. When you combine emotions and logic, then you can change the other person's point of view. Let's say that your friend wants to open the restaurant, but you want to start a digital agency. For a long time, you've been planning to cooperate and start the business together, but now your views are different about the business that you should start. So instead of trying to convince each other, you can start a discussion with the fact that you both want to start a business and how this will be beneficial for both of you in future, and then see where the conversation takes you from there. I hope you enjoyed this The Art of Logic book summary and you learned how to make sense in a world that doesn't. The bottom line is that logic is a good thing as it can help you to make better decisions, but you have to be aware that you can't always use it. If you enjoyed this video, then make sure you hit that like button. And if you're new to this channel, then type new in the comments below. If you want to learn how to set better goals, make better decisions, and build solid structure in your life, then check out my free Productivity Mastermind course to take your productivity to the next level. Also, be sure to subscribe and hit the bell icon so you don't miss my upcoming videos.